I don't have good habits. I have changed my diet none whatsoever since I was a kid. I still drink whole milk every day. That's weird in a lot of places now. Like even in, I went in Starbucks and the kid's really nice and I know they have whole milk because it's in a silver container and it says whole milk. And there's one right next to it that says skim, it's for your coffee, but they're not selling whole milk. And I said to the kid, I go, I know this might sound weird, but if I gave you money, would you give me some milk? And he goes, would you like to try our soy milk? I said, I don't know. I went to bed at 11 o'clock last night. I didn't watch the news. And you're the first person I've spoken to since I woke up today while I was asleep. Did all the cows in the world die? Because if so, I would like to try your soy milk. If not, I do not understand why that was thrown out as an alternative to my original request. If you want to feel better about your health and you want to feel like a really in shape, healthy person, even if you're not, go on a cruise ship for a week. A lot of drinkers and eaters on those ships. It'll drink and eat you into feeling great. I had never been on a cruise ship ever. And Lewis Black booked a comedy cruise and made me go. And I got to Miami. I'd never even seen a cruise ship up close. They're humongous. It holds 4,000 people. It's gigantic. My sister goes, what was it like? Maybe me and Matt will go. I go, here's what it was like. Picture if we were all in Las Vegas, standing in the Bellagio, and all of a sudden, it just sailed away. Yeah. The whole building, and nobody panicked. Or acting weird. I say, bye. Hey, want to try a monkey ass rum punch? Yes, I love monkey ass rum punch. 7 monkey rum punches later, you hear, and now we will be doing the safety drill. What? What? I'm hammered. I can't do a safety drill. It is on your muster station, which is located on the back of your key card. It will not match your deck or room, so please pay. What?
Now there's math involved. This is a terrible vacation. There's no math on vacation.
I don't even understand the difference between the deficit and the debt. And my brother is the financial advisor, and he's younger than me, and he knows how to speak, like, you know, down to my level. And I said, Pat, in an easy way, explain to me what is the difference between the deficit and the debt. He goes, okay, I will. Just pay attention. And he started talking. And I don't know how far in it was. I would say probably the 42nd mark, I drifted out a lot, right? But he didn't catch me until about the 90-second mark. And he's like, are you even paying attention anymore? I go, no, but I gotta tell you what I have been doing. I heard about this and now I'm doing it and you have to do it at work because it'll make you smile and laugh so hard. If you go to Google and type in Batman cat and then hit images, oh my God, it's the funniest thing I've ever seen. It's real, Pat. It's not a joke. It's a real cat. It's a long-haired black guy, and they combed his hair, and it looks like the Batman mask. And yeah, I mean, they're holding him up, but that's not cheating. I mean, they're just holding him. And if I don't know if it's for sale, like, I don't even want a cat, but I want that cat. So every morning I'd wake up, he'd be on my chest, I'm Batman. Yes, you are. Yes, you are. I would never not have a happy day if I owned that cat. He's like, Kathleen, I'm at work. Yeah, whatever. I gotta go. Yeah, but that's what we're doing all day, Obama. I don't have time to help you. The Batman cat is trying to get some popularity going. And you know, I wish, like, I try to pay attention. It's also just too difficult. I mean, you know, a long time ago it wasn't hard. There was the morning newspaper and then the evening news. And the evening news wasn't a joke. No, they didn't talk about the Kardashians or Paris Hilton. It was just some old, mean white man who'd come out, smoke a cigarette, always very angry. Hello! Welcome to the Nightly News. Tonight, we're gonna talk about Korea. And if you don't know where Korea is, get a goddamn map, you unpatriotic son of a bitch. You're like, oh my God, where's Korea? Hurry up, find out. He's gonna know we don't know. Oh my God, I'm petrified of this person. Yeah, now, there's a million news channels, there's a million websites, CNN.com. Here's Obama's healthcare plan. Boom, it's right there, 1,087 pages. Okay, and then right next to that, there's a video. It's 2 minutes and 17 seconds long, and it says, baby owls live in teacups. Hello. Yeah, I realize I've never seen a baby owl, and I don't know why, and I want to see it. And why is it in a teacup? And why is this crazy old lady allowed to do this? And why isn't PETA over there beating the crap out of her? There's so many questions I have about this video. I'm interested. They're up all the time. It doesn't matter what time you call the house, one of them's up. Yeah, oh, it could be 2 in the afternoon, 3 in the morning, 5 a.m., 11, hello. Yeah, they're up. They call me from weird places. It's 6 a.m. where I am. It's 5 a.m. where they are. Hello. Oh, what are you doing? More importantly, what are you doing, Mom? Well, we're in Home Depot's parking lot. We thought they opened at 6, they don't. So we're just gonna sit here for an hour and look at the other old people that were confused by their ad. I said, Mom, why aren't you sleeping anymore? Well, don't tell your father this, because he'll be embarrassed, but now we're afraid we're gonna die in our sleep. So, we've decided we'll just stay up, and one of us will be up, and then we'll nap, because you never hear somebody dying while they were napping. You don't hear, oh, he died in his nap. You hear they died in their sleep, but if we both fall asleep, we won't know the other one's dead, and that's how things get out of hand. Okay. Okay, Mom. I went to Target with her. My mom was a nurse for 30 years. She's retired. I said, out of nowhere, while we're pushing a cart, God, I have a splitting sinus headache. She goes, oh, here, and roots through her giant purse and goes, take this. And I took it. And about a second later, I hear, oh. I said, what was that all about? She goes, you swallow that? Yep, sure did. Swallowed it. What color was it? I don't know, Mom. I don't know. I didn't look at what color it was. Kathleen, why didn't you look at what color the pill was? What? Why? Why? Because you're not somebody I met at a party. You were my mom. You were a nurse for 30 years. I bought the whole story. I did. I trusted you. I ate it blind. I just ate it blind. I said, well, if you had to guess, what kind of pill do you think I ate? She said, well, I don't know. It's hard to tell. It came out of the blue unmarked bottle that your father and I call the All-Stars. And it could be anything from pain medication to blood pressure pills, Kathleen. I said, what if it's his blood pressure medication? She said, you're gonna pass out. And that's why we should abandon our carts and leave this Target immediately, because I can't drag you out of here with this bad knee. That knee replacement did not work. I don't care what he says, it didn't work. And you're not gonna want me to drive home, Kathleen, because it takes forever, because I don't make left turns anymore. Now I don't even care what kind of pill I ate. Now I just want to understand why she doesn't make left turns anymore. I saw, it's not always lefts. It's anything into oncoming traffic or you have to cross lanes to get to your lanes. UPS doesn't allow their drivers to do it and they save millions of dollars. Your father and I retired. We have that kind of time. You drive to the next light and you cautiously make a U-turn, Kathleen. That's what you do. I don't smoke pot. I never cared for it. But I'm very happy for my pot friends that this year, finally in government, something did change. A little bit of pot became legal in certain cities. Yeah, because I have plenty of pothead friends, and they're very nice people. They don't do anything bad at all. They don't really do anything at all. Like, they're just low-key people. They don't bother anybody. They're not a pain in my ass. My drinking friends, yeah, they're a pain in my ass. I don't get calls from my pothead friends at 3 a.m. Can you come get me? I'm in jail. I'm so thin. I hit a lake. When did they put a lake on Highway 40? This is ridiculous. There was no lake there. Seriously. You gotta bring 10 grand. Can you do that? It was always the argument against pot that I always found so, it was just so fantastical. People would go so crazy. You cannot legalize marijuana. It is a gateway drug for Christ's sake. It is a gateway drug. If you legalize marijuana, the next thing you know, after a person smokes pot, they will be shooting heroin in a crack house in Cleveland with a dog named Banjo they didn't purchase.
What? That's crazy.
And it's a bad premise. Not everything's a gateway. That's where your premise is bad. Okay, when you were 5 and you stole a candy bar and you ate it and it was delicious, was your next thought, you know what? I'm gonna kill a drifter. No. No. I've smoked cigarettes a lot of my life. I finally quit. I didn't want to quit. People who have never been addicted to anything never truly get it.
Like, oh my God, you quit smoking. Do you feel better?
No. No. Love to shove your face through glass just for saying that. And then smoke whatever's left on the other side. That's how irritable I am right now about the fact that I can't smoke cigarettes. Just not that healthy of a person. I joined a gym. And then my gym closed. And then I had to go join another gym. That's a pain in the ass. Because you can't just pay and go in. You have to have a meeting and a consultation with somebody. Really? I don't want to. Well, you have to, Kathleen. You have to meet with Cindy. Oh. Okay. Great. Cindy is 21. Cindy is in shape. Cindy is happy to be alive. Everything is going great in Cindy's world. You get the happiest thing ever. But her voice is so high. The tone and the pitch. When she spoke, all I heard was a Yorkie barking. I swear to God, that's all I heard. Hi, I'm going to the gym. I'm in K. Phillips Ford. I was like, really? I gotta speak to this lady? Like, I have money. Can't I just go in? No. Okay, Kathleen, before you can get in and everything, okay, we have to write down some of your goals. Cindy, I don't have any goals here. Maybe that's weird, but I don't have any goals. I'm not here for offense, Cindy. I'm here for defense. There's a big difference. I am here to try and pull a fourth quarter Hail Mary pass out of my ass before things get weird. Now, I don't know if that's possible, but I'm willing to pay $62 a month to not come here and find out. But Kathleen, that's so sad. No, it's not sad. It's just, well, I have to put something in the form or I'm gonna get in trouble. Okay, here's my goal. Ready? Here's my goal. I am here to delay the date and severity of my impending stroke.
Dad, you don't see the gym as a fun place.
Well, I don't, Cindy. And I think at my age, I think I know what's fun. to me, and I think I know what's not fun to me. A bar is fun to me. Trust me, year after year, I reprove it and reprove it. I really have a lot of fun in a bar. A gym? No. No, no. I've never stayed at a gym so long I got kicked out. Never. I never worked out so hard somebody had to take my keys because I was crazy. No. Mitt Romney said after many, many months, many, many months of thinking about why he lost the election, and you can Google this, he said he realized that it was mainly because he didn't tweet enough.
Really?
That's what you're going to tell yourself where you go to sleep at night. You was just one tweet away from winning. It's amazing how people can fool themselves. I didn't vote for Mitt Romney. It had nothing to do with politics. I didn't vote for Mitt Romney. I will never vote for Mitt Romney because he said, and I know he's telling the truth, because they would have proved differently. The press would have, and he's a devout Mormon, so I completely believe him, that at age 65, in his life, he had never had a drink, a drug, a cigarette, or a cigar. Ever. As an Irish Catholic, that sentence couldn't even go in my head. I just, air. Invalid information, rephrase question, check age. Because I said to my brother, think about it, Pat. The only people that we know that can truly say that are babies. And that's just because they don't know yet. Yes, they like juice, but they haven't had a Bud Light. They don't know. And I judged him for that. And that's not fair to that man, but I did. I judged him. Because to me, a glass of wine or a cigarette or maybe a Lunesta, one of my favorites. If you've never taken a Lunesta, but you've seen the commercial, I'm here to let you in on a little secret. That neon butterfly is real. Yeah. Wow. Green, pink, they're beautiful. But those are the ways a normal adult relieves stress to me. Well, a cigar, maybe some pot, whatever it is you do. And if you don't do any of them, my mind goes to alarm state where I go, uh-oh, alien, I think you're sleeping with a goat. That's how weird it is to me. That's not fair to Mitt Romney. You wonder about our government spending money. You wonder who makes these decisions. Because Lewis and I have gone to Iraq and Afghanistan over and over. And we, oh, please, no, that's okay. That's very kind that you clap. Yeah, I don't even say that for applause, because really, I wouldn't go if I remembered the number and didn't pick up. It's just, I'm too Catholic and I'm too guilty to say no. I can't lie like that. I'm a terrible liar. They would know I was lying. Oh no, I'm just, no, I just go. But Afghanistan, I mean, the unbelievable. I don't even understand. You get there and you're like, what are we going for here? Cause they, it's a horrible, horrible place. It's freezing, which you would never think, because on the news, when you see the Taliban guys, they're always just in a sheet. They don't have like a, like wearing a parka and mittens and stuff. It looks like fall, and you wear your sheet wear and you run around and looks like fall. And I always thought that's why I would be a horrible terrorist, because I'm already prone to naps. And if you put me in a sheet all day, oh my God, forget it. I would never leave the cave. I would be the worst terrorist ever. I'd be like, yeah, I know everybody's really mad, but I'm just gonna guard the cave while you guys go do that. And I'm gonna take a nice nap in this thread count. Have you felt my thread count? And I have a pillow conveniently located on the top of my head. It's freezing. It's like 10 degrees in Afghanistan, and there's sand flying in your face at all times. I don't care what direction you look, there's sand flying in your face. So it doesn't even make sense in my Midwest mind, if sand's flying in my face, I should be in a swimming suit holding a multicolored alcoholic drink I forgot I loved. Like, rum, I love rum. I haven't had this since I vomited in high school.
This is delicious.
It's just, it's free, because my brother goes, how bad was it? I go, here's how bad it was, Pat. Here's what I want you to do. Go out into your garage, take off all your clothes, get into your walk-in freezer, and then every 15 minutes, I'm gonna come out there and throw sand in your face. Yeah. They flew us around in Black Hawk helicopters. The doors are open, people are shooting at you. You can see the ground, because that's how close you are to the ground, which is creepy. And at one point, it's very loud, you have these headphone things on. We flew over a bunch of camels just running around. And Lou goes, are those wild? I said, I don't know what you mean by that. But I don't see saddles on them. And I don't see tiny monkey jockeys, and I don't see a betting window, so I don't think we're at a camel track. Yes, I think they're wild. He goes, where are we? I don't know, but from what I can see, I'd say we'd flown to the Bible. And the Old Testament, Lou, the bad Bible, where shit's on fire for no reason. God is a lunatic. You're misbehaving. I'm throwing locusts at your heads. Blah, blah, blah. Not the New Testament, Lou. Not the fun Bible where there's wine and cheese parties and people are getting risen from the dead. Hey, I'm back. I'm back. I'm Lazarus. I was dead an hour ago. I don't understand what's happening. Where's the wine? I heard he's making wine somewhere. That guy. Love that guy. That's how horrible it is. And you go, really? This is what we're spending our money on? And they go, Kathleen, you know, we hardly ever have female entertainers. You should go down to the female marine tent and have a little talk with them. I said, okay. So I go down there, I go, what do you ladies do all day on the base? They go, oh, we go into the local Taliban-run town and speak to the women, the locals, about women's rights. Really? I go, do you speak Afghani or whatever it is? And they were like, no. I go, do they speak English? They were like, no. Let me get this straight. Our federal government's paying for you to go into a Taliban-run town and play a game of charades with a lady dressed up like a beekeeper and try to trick her into leaving her husband, who thinks it's the year 11, by the way, and he liked that year. That was a great year if you were a dude, 11. I just don't see that happening. Call me a pessimist. I just don't see that lady whipping that burqa off and going, that's it, Muhammad, seriously, I've had it. I've had it. It is cool to see your parents get older, though, and not care anymore. Because there's 7 kids in my family. They were as strict as you could be, but now they're grandparents. My one brother's got 3 boys. They're 4, 2, and nothing, whatever you call that. I don't know, he's new. And my parents volunteered to babysit for 3 days while him and his wife went away. I said, oh, I'll come down and help you for a couple days. I'm off in the middle. Sure, I'll help. And my dad, very patient. My mom, still not even to this day. She told the older one, Patrick, I need you to put the iPad down. He goes, no. Wow. Look at the guts on him. She told me to eat a pill, and I just did it. At this age, like, I don't know. I didn't even look at what color it was. That's how obedient I am. Wow, look at this guy. Look at this guy. 4. No. She said, Patrick, I'm not kidding. My son put the iPad down. He goes, No. And he shut the door right at her. Went, and my mom unravels. Jack, did you see what he did? Did you see what that little son of a bitch did? Vicky, you are 70. He is 4. Get a handle on yourself. We can't reparent these people in 3 days. I don't care what goes on here. It's our job to get out alive, okay? I don't care if he eats the iPad. I don't. We'll buy another iPad. That's what we'll do. All I know is 2 hours before they get home, we're going to shower the 3 of them, put them on the couch and go, they were lovely. And then we're going to the casino. That's how this is going to end.
And they've gotten more liberal the older they've got, which is weird because usually your parents go the other way. Like the very first Obama election, I wanted Hillary. My parents are old school Democrats, but my dad does not like the Clintons. He hates the Clintons because of NAFTA. He's never going to get over NAFTA.
How could you think about supporting that woman? She was with him the whole way on NAFTA, the whole way.
And if you'd like to know exactly what's wrong with NAFTA and the problems that it has caused this country, you can call 573-348, blah, 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 ask for Jack, and you will get a 2-hour dissertation on why exactly this country has fallen apart. I said, I want to go to Detroit. And they said, why? I said, 2 reasons. I'm not sure I'm fond of all of you. And I know that in Detroit, at any given moment, something weird and bad could happen to all of you. And second of all, the people in Detroit, perhaps for you who haven't read it, those of you who haven't read a newspaper, are the most optimistic people. They're still there. Do you understand? They are still there. 60 Minutes has covered it, 2020 has covered it, the New York Times has covered it. And what is the conversation at the dinner table? Well, something's gonna happen. It's gotta turn around. I mean, I don't know when, but I'm certainly not leaving yet. I have hope. I do. I mean, that Kwame Kilpatrick was crazy. But you move on. You do. You move on. And you find a better man. I do love this city. It's, and, you know, I don't know if this is progress, but normally, and this is my city included, we're usually flip-flop in number one and number two in murder. It's usually Detroit and then St. Louis, which is why I feel so close to you people. I understand the element that you live with, that at any moment, shit could get weird. Just driving down the road, you don't know, things could get weird. But this year, oh, no. Number one, Flint. Yeah. I'm like, how? How is that possible? There's not even any people there. Are they just shooting people that drive by and counting that? Are they, like, tricking people to Flint? Free money, and then they shoot them and go, there's another one. We're so going to win this year. And I don't think it's fair that Detroit dropped to number 3 just because you've actually shot everyone. Just because you did a good job doesn't mean you should lose Cold Red King. Because there's lovely parts of Detroit here, this whole area. People don't know that, though. They only know what you see on the news. You know, are you afraid to go to Detroit? No, I'm not afraid to go to Detroit. I'm not afraid of normal things. It amazes me when my friend is a DVD distributor and he's like, you know what, people love horror movies because teenagers, they love to pay to be frightened. I go, that's because they have not lived long enough to know that real life will scare the shit out of you. There is no reason to go pay to be scared. Because at this age, I could care less if a vampire walked in my house. I truly wouldn't even blink an eye. But look at this mole. Yeah, that scares me. Look at that mole. Yeah. It's got ridges on it now. It didn't 3 weeks ago.
but I don't have time to go to a doctor, so I just ask other comedians. They're like, hey, does that look fucked up to you? And they go, no. I go, cool. And then I go have another beer and forget about it. Yeah. Really? You're going to pay to be scared? I'll scare you. Here's a letter from the IRS. Do you want to open that now or after you've eaten lunch and you can vomit your $8 lunch special? I'm not afraid of a burglar. I'm afraid of the mailman. That's who I'm afraid of. That son of a bitch hasn't brought anything good to my house since I was 10. That's the last time I got a birthday card with money in it. That was it. Ever since then, nothing. I have friends that when they raise the price of a stamp, my friends will go insane. Yeah, young people in their 30s and 40s. It's not old people on a budget. 30-year-olds. Oh my God, they raised the price of stamp. Jesus Christ, this is highway robbery. This federal government, this. Really? It's 49 cents. You're angry about that? Because I feel the exact opposite way. I cannot believe to this day that I can walk into a building with a piece of paper in my hand and look at a full-grown adult and go, hey, 49 cents, will you take this to Alaska? They go, yes, ma'am. We'll have it there in 2 days. Is there anything else you'd like? More stamps. This is crazy. And then the government's cutting some of the poor stuff. That makes me sad.